It was difficult to reach Black Canyon by car in the early 1960s. There were not many paved roads crossing Colorado, and interstates were not yet developed. Yet, there was one young man driven to experience the canyon through the growing sport of rock climbing, and his forceful driving across those Colorado roads was legendary. That man was Layton Kor. Growing up near the larger cities of Colorado, Kor first began climbing cliffs and crags in the mountains outside of Denver. A friend introduced him to the Black, as it became known, by showing him slides from a sightseeing trip in 1962. They took off for an adventure the next weekend. He would coax and cajole any one of a number of friends to join him in pioneering climbs in the Black, and he gained a reputation of extraordinary first ascents during the decade. There were no easy routes to scramble down to the bottom to begin a climb, and there were very few people who could suggest the most direct ways in. Kor, with characteristic enthusiasm, plowed ahead. His second climb, the Southern Arete, is downstream a little ways from here. They spent too much time getting to the cliff base that morning and got a late start. The early climbing was very difficult, and twilight settled on them before they could reach the top. A nice open ledge presented itself, though, and they camped. Some brushwood provided fuel for a fire. Combined with a can of beans and a loaf of bread, they dined on hot bean sandwiches. They finished the route early the next morning. Across the canyon is the scene of one of Kor's most difficult explorations. The idea for the climb arose one evening in a house in Boulder where climbers often hung out. Kor had been studying North Chasm Wall and figured that some of the crack systems would make for what was then the most difficult climb in the state. Piling into his 57 Ford, he was joined by Jim McCarthy, Will Bassett, and Tex Bossier. The weather forced them to abandon their first attempt, and Bassett bowed out. The remaining three followed the huge, obvious crack that runs most of the distance up the wall. Working their way up the cliff was strenuous, but hauling bags of gear and the crumbling nature of the rocks slowed them down. 3 days into the climb, they reached the overhanging rock slabs at the top of the crack, where some of the hardest climbing of this route is found. After examining this stretch of the climb, Kor turned to McCarthy and suggested, "I think I'd better lead this pitch. I'm not married." Although joking, it took him 8 hours to zigzag through the maze of cracks and overhangs. He later commented that it was the most difficult artificial pitch he had ever made. The other two still needed to follow. Bossier, sitting in his harness 150 feet below Kor, slowly swung 30 feet out from the cliff face to ascend directly up to the belay ledge where Kor was sitting. With nerves of steel, Bossier pulled himself up the ropes to the ledge, gazing between his shoes some 2,000 feet to the canyon floor below. They were near the top, however, and the 5-day excursion was soon finished. Other climbers added new routes slowly after Kor's 1963 adventure. Some of these routes received colorful names like No Pig Left, The Plunge, Air Voyage, and Eighth Voyage of Sinbad. Kor continued his pioneering climbs, gaining a colorful reputation and becoming Colorado's most respected climber. While he has added new routes to the Black since the 1960s, the effort he led on North Chasm Wall stands out as a singular achievement in the world of climbing.